Bukit Panjang LRT is the automated people mover system operated in Bukit Panjang, a township in northwest Singapore. With a length of 8 km, Bukit Panjang LRT connects the township of Bukit Panjang with Chua Chu Kang MRT station and Bukit Panjang MRT station. Despite its LRT branding, Bukit Panjang LRT is not the same as other LRT around the world. I will elaborate further. This LRT line is a proof of concept for the future, as there were more LRT lines planned across the island in the 1990s. The future that is not happened and replaced with another type of transit that is more practical in the present time. Let's take a ride on an automated pod and understand of the reasons of why $280 million was spent to serve a neighborhood and why there is no more new LRT lines in Singapore after 2005. Located about 16 kilometers from the city, Bukit Panjang is a township located northwest of Singapore. With more than 138,000 people live in Bukit Panjang in the year 2023, the high population number justified the need of an efficient transit system. To understand the need for the light rail solution, we need to briefly understand the development in Bukit Panjang. The name Bukit Panjang is derived from Malay words which means long hill. Located nearby the hilly Central Catchment Reserve area, Bukit Panjang got its name from its hilly terrain that would be clearly visible by looking at the LRT tracks. When the township was developed by Housing and Development Board or HDB in 1981, the planning area was called Chong Hua but reverted back to Bukit Panjang as the homage to the original name. In addition, Bukit Panjang used to exist as a constituency between 1955 until 1972, before being reinstated as a single-member constituency or SMC in the year 2006. However, several places adapted the name Chong Hua, such as Chong Hua Secondary School and Chong Hua Park. Due to the national policies of restricting car ownership, public transportation becomes the default mode of commuting and moving around. As the township and population grew, bus service is not enough to serve the increasingly dense Bukit Panjang township. Queue and long waiting time was common in the early 1990s. To encourage the real estate development and connectivity in a historically remote or ulu area, a transit line was planned to link Bukit Panjang with the MRT network in some way. Building an MRT branch is prohibitively expensive, and Chua Chu Kang station itself is a part of branch line until 1996, when the line is integrated with North-South Line or NSL. Bukit Panjang residents did ask for MRT extension, but the geography becomes the barrier. It is technically easier to build an elevated MRT tracks on flat land from Woodlands to Chua Chu Kang than passing through hilly and protected Central Catchment Reserve area. First envisioned within Concept Plan 1991, the second long-term national development plan, LRT envisioned as a feeder to the built and planned MRT lines, where the line is too short for an MRT and too long for a bus. The transit solution should be a grade separated from the road, more reliable and more accessible than bus. Feasibility studies were conducted in 1994 and the construction started in 1996 with a cost of $285 million. The construction was completed in 1999 and the Bukit Panjang LRT opened to the public on 6th of November 1999. There are 13 operating stations in Bukit Panjang LRT line, and some of the names are derived from the former kampung streets which used to exist in the area. Bukit Panjang, as been explained earlier, it means long hill. Pete means thunder. Boom! Pending is a traditional Malay buckle worn to secure the sarong on the waist and to protect the lower stomach part. Bangkit could mean rise up or wake up, because fajar means sunrise, it is time to wake up. Segar means fresh. Jelapang means wide open space, could be grass or paddy, just like the word jelapang padi, paddy field. Senja means sunset, and here is the interesting thing. Senja located at the west, fajar located at the east. Sunset the west, sunrise at the east. Makes sense, right? Phoenix is named after nearby Phoenix Road. Phoenix itself is a mighty mythical immortal bird in the ancient literatures. Tekwai is named after the locality of Tekwai. Keat Hong is named after the Keat Hong constituency. South View is located in the middle of Choa Chu Kang, west of Bukit Panjang. To the local of South Viewians, may you explain in the comment section the origin story of South View, because there is little information available online. Despite its name, Bukit Panjang LRT is not in the same category as the other operating LRT lines elsewhere in the world. The system is an Automated People Mover, APM, which has more commonality with Airport SkyTrain than the other light transit lines. Example, LRT in Kuala Lumpur, such as in Kelana Jaya Line, is a fully functioning metro system that carries more than 230,000 passengers per day. I talked about the Kelana Jaya LRT line long time ago when it was broke down in the year 2022 and why this line is the most important transit line in KL. LRT in North America is a rail system that shares the lane with other road traffic, which is called tram in the rest of the world. Therefore, Bukit Panjang LRT is one of its kind. The rolling stocks are not fitted with the steel tyres, they move by a set of rubber tyres on concrete tracks. Rubber tyres are chosen as it is relatively quieter than the steel rail, since the line will pass by close to the flats, very close. With a weight of 15 tons per car, it is not lightweight either. Perhaps because it is lighter than the MRT carriage, perhaps it is considered light. Bukit Panjang LRT poised as the cost-saving solution for a localized transit system that is great separated from the road and is cheaper to build than MRT underground or even an elevated one and not stuck in the traffic and at the traffic light, like the buses or trams. However, there are issues that makes the system less attractive and reliable than MRT. Number 1, track layout. LRT tracks was built after the completion of HDB flats, which explain its nearness to someone's house. To speed up the project and minimize the disturbance on road traffic, LRT tracks were built on the space between the road and the flats. If the tracks was built at the road median, in the middle of the road, it will cause road congestion and bus delays, since one or two lanes need to be closed for the construction works. Therefore, the rolling stocks were installed with this magically misting glass that's supposed to fog when passing by the flats and turn clear when approaching the station. Due to upgrading works since 2018, the glass has turned opaque permanently, makes the LRT journey a little bit more claustrophobic than the underground MRT trains. Number 2, the stations. All LRT stations are elevated, which makes the LRT line separated from the road traffic. The excellent covered walkway makes the LRT stations accessible by walking and cycling. All stations are equipped with lift and essential barrier-free amenities for the elderly and disabled. Sometimes when I use the lift on a generic LRT station, some elderly person will give a stare to a person that seems fit enough, strong enough to use a stair. Stairs, fit for a fit people. From the fare gate, narrow stairs connect the ground level to the platform level, useful when the lift is crowded. And there is no escalator going up down in the whole LRT system. Either wait for the lift or use the stairs, which limit the capacity of the people able to go up and down from the platform. And number 3, the ride itself. By technical definition, Bukit Panjang LRT is an APM that is widely used in airports. A flat land and straight line makes the APM operation smooth and comfortable. In fact, the same rolling stock model used to operate as Changi Airport SkyTrain until 2006. I talked about the Changi Airport in the previous video, where Changi Airport SkyTrain connects Terminal 1, Terminal 2 and Terminal 3 and passing through Jewel. Beautiful. The link will be appeared up here. Bukit Panjang, as its name, is a hilly area adding with the sharp corners, which makes the ride bumpy. To conserve the limited space in the island nation, the LRT depot is located within 10 Mile Junction Complex, which is called Junction 10 today. Between 1999 until 2019, there is an LRT station called 10 Mile Junction in the complex, which also housed Shopee Mall. The frequency is up to 20 minutes. Who is willing to wait that long for a train? On 30th of January 2019, 10 Mile Junction station is closed, the first and the only transit station in Singapore that has been out of operation. Together with the closure of 10 Mile Junction station, the service C has been terminated and allows for an expansion of the LRT depot within the building. To improve the reliability and comfortability, $344 million Singaporean dollars has been awarded to the original rolling stock supplier Bombardier to upgrade the system, scheduled to be completed by 2026. There are several reasons of why LRT was built and will be likely remain in operation in the future for many years to come. The reason number one is political pressure. In an article published by Singaporean media dated 12th of September 2017, Bukit Panjang LRT was built due to political pressure back in 1994. The main reason is the implementation of Certificate of Entitlement or COE, which limits the ownership of private vehicles enforced since 1990. People who live far from MRT station need to choose between an expensive car or slow and overcrowded bus. When one of the members of parliament raised the issue of the rising price of COE, the response is not more cars, but better public transport. Reason number 2, real estate. Due to its location up in the northwest of the island, the location is less attractive than the townships that located nearer to the city. The convenience and accessibility of LRT makes the price of the house increase when the LRT construction has started, according to the Straits Times on the 27th of May 1996. Bukit Panjang LRT, sometimes labeled as Kajet Ban or some expensive transit solution due to its operation high cost, limited capacity and limited capability to increase its capacity. Regardless of the label, Bukit Panjang LRT is there to stay as the transit system is more accessible than bus. With that, the number 3, accessibility. There are calls to shut down the LRT and replace the line with bus services that is cheaper to run and cheaper to maintain with excellent efficiency. However, for the wheelchair users, strollers and other type of people with disabilities, LRT is more accessible than bus, and boarding time on LRT is faster than the bus despite of all the LRT shortcomings. Let me explain. In one of the series of disability equality training or DET, a bus captain need to disembark going off from the bus and unfold the ramp to allow a wheelchair user to embark and disembark the bus. Therefore, the waiting time on the bus stop will be longer than usual if there is a wheelchair user, and the bus might risk of a travel delay, causing dismay to the other passengers waiting inside. Of course, there is a technology to unfold the bus ramp automatically, but the implementation across the country will take some time, and extra time is still needed to unfold and fold the ramp. As LRT has no driver and accessible by the lift, the boarding time is similar to the able-bodied people. Thus, LRT will stay at it is more accessible and convenient to ride than the bus, despite the cost and reliability. Why did I highlight the accessibility? With the declining birth rate and aging population at par with what happened in the developed countries, Singapore is projected to have a larger percentage of elderly population in the next decades. It is projected by 2030, just a few years from now, one of four Singaporeans will be 65 years old or older. Therefore, the current infrastructure should be accessible to the elderly, the disabled, the young, and the rest of us. After the completion of Bukit Panjang LRT in the year 1999, there are two new LRT lines that will be built in the northeast. And after that, no more new LRT lines. Sengkang LRT line was opened in 2003, while Punggol LRT line was opened by stages from 2005 until 2014. Unlike in Bukit Panjang, Sengkang and Punggol LRT lines use Mitsubishi Crystal Mover, which is similar to the latest Changi Airport SkyTrain train sets. Perhaps a suitable topic for the next video. Except the rolling stock used, Sengkang and Punggol LRT lines are similarly designed as Bukit Panjang LRT line, which caused several issues on cost, accessibility and ride comfort. Thus, the island-wide plan for LRT was simply scrapped. The LRT route plan for Marina Line and Queenstown Line eventually became the basis for MRT Circle Line alignment. Plan route for LRT in Tampines becomes the part eastern part of the Downtown Line alignment, of which DTL started at Bukit Panjang. Today, Bukit Panjang LRT continues to run, serving the locals from their homes nearby to Bukit Panjang MRT Station and Choa Chu Kang MRT Station, which makes the line one of its kind in Singapore. If you want to ride Bukit Panjang LRT, the line is intersect with Choa Chu Kang MRT Station on the NSL and Bukit Panjang MRT Station on the DTL. There are local buses serving Bukit Panjang and connections to the other parts of Singapore. By road, Bukit Panjang is served by Bukit Timah Expressway, BKE, Kranji Expressway or KJE, Upper Bukit Timah Road from the south and Woodlands Road from the north. There are a few attractions nearby Bukit Panjang LRT. There is Chestnut Nature Park near Pending LRT Station and Hillion Mall and Bukit Panjang Plaza to shop. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something new about Bukit Panjang LRT and why the transit line is one of its kind in Singapore. Thank you so much for watching again and see you in the next video.